This is WOTN Cleveland. I'm your host, Joshua Vialta. And this is WOTN Cleveland. We'll be right back. Hey man, get the juice flowing. Come on. Let's go. What's wrong?
How many times I gotta tell you, you gotta buffer up the song, man?
It's 2017, it should already be done.
It's not.
Why is it taking so long? Don't give me attitude, woman. Take off my clothes
with
this, man. Do you feel like it?
Yeah,
we took the standard format of the documentary and threw it out the window.
The esports community is a lot more than just being good at a video game. You have to actually work on marketing yourself. Sponsorships are not going to fall into your lap. You have to work for them.
How to make a living as a gamer is stupid.
But it is possible. But just be realistic.
I understand that competitive gaming is exactly what the name insists. But what the community needs to remember is that we all come together for a common reason, and that's based off of our love for the game. It's all about having fun.
WOTN Cleveland. I sure enjoyed that commercial. I hope you did. We have a new segment since it's the new year. It's called the pain level. Bring in the pain. Level 2 of pain level. Bring in the next thing. Plug it in. Level 3 of pain. This is WOTN Cleveland. I'm your host, Joshua Vialta. And we will be right back. Motherfucker, wake up! Wake up! Wake up! Wake up! Hey, man!
Listen.
Come on, you're on the show. You
can I get some sleep? Can I get some sleep?
I told you to play.
All I do is rave. Can I get some sleep?
No, you're on my show. You play.
Oh, put this on auto DJ, okay?
All right, man. I'll see you in 5 minutes. Who I saw was not a person I could touch.
And she said that she's seen a lady in a white dress come through the door down here and walk straight to the basement.
So I turn on the light. There's nobody there.
I thought for sure someone had followed me down here.
Did one of you just say no?
No. I came back like this. They were gone.
multiple people
yes.
are seeing the same thing. That's incredible.
To WOTN in Cleveland, and we have a segment called Who the Hell Is That? I have Eric and Sean from Ecotvision Paranormal, correct?
Hi. Yep.
How's it going, guys?
It's great. Thanks for having us.
I'm pretty good. Kind of cool. Like, I never had a paranormal team on my show before, but I'm totally down. I have a serious question for the both of you two.
Okay.
Eric, what kind of cotton swabs do you use? That thing is clean. I want to get up in there.
It's just Q-tip brand.
Sean. What kind of dental floss do you use? Your teeth? I would eat off that. I would do your teeth.
It's just a regular Oral-B.
Okay, then. We're moving on. Second question. Eric and Sean, where do you see your guys' self in 10 minutes?
Someplace better.
Someplace better than WOT in Cleveland? No way.
Hey, we're.
You're gonna be
life gets better and better.
No, you're gonna be over here, then you're gonna be over there.
Sure.
Don't be doing that. Serious question though, guys. Where do you guys see Ecotvision Paranormal going? Where do you guys see where that leading? And how's your experiences as those kind of guys? Like, I love this talking to, like, watching the shows and doing, you know, what you guys do.
Mm-hmm.
So give us a little detail about that.
That's a really good question. You know, the future, it's uncertain, but our hopes are that we just get out there and we're able to help as many people as we can with the trouble that they're having in their homes.
Okay. What's the scariest thing? It can go same time or you've ever encountered?
Feel it.
Well, the scariest thing I ever encountered, it was when I was a kid, honestly. It was about a 7-foot shadow man that walked across my bedroom.
Yeah.
And I was like 20 years old.
That.
Yeah.
I'm good on that, man.
Right?
What about you, man?
I was about 5 years old, and I lived on a farmhouse, and I saw what appeared to be a man 6 foot tall, wearing a red jogging suit with white pinstripes down the sides.
Yeah.
And as he walked, he kind of walked really strangely. I don't know if you've ever seen that fast, jerky motion in a movie.
Yeah.
It resembled that, but
he was like a glitch almost?
Almost.
Like he was walking.
Yeah, I guess you could say that. But his motions, they weren't natural.
Right.
They were very jerky and unnatural.
Right.
And as I saw him cut through the field, he kind of glanced at me and grinned and bared his teeth. And then he kind of fell towards some tall grass and disappeared.
Okay.
So that was very frightening for me as a 5-year old.
Yeah, I can imagine. Yeah, man.
Yeah, so.
We actually have some of your guys' work we're going to be showing.
Awesome, thank you.
No problem. What do you guys got going on? Any new hauntings coming up you guys are checking out? Or?
We're scheduling a lot of home investigations currently.
Okay.
And right now in the books, we are scheduled to go to a place called the Hinsdale House.
Ooh,
it's
okay.
A place out in New York. Nicknamed the Demon House. There's been exorcisms there, all of which I believe have not had any effect. So there's still a lot of negative kind of energy there.
I dig it. That's spooky, man. All right, so we're gonna take a quick commercial break, and when we come back, you guys get a chance to win $1. Both of you
yes.
two get a dollar.
Sweet.
Yes. That's the only reason I came on.
I know.
Yep.
All right, this is WOTN Cleveland, and we'll be right back. Come on, man!
Our national Fear Face competition winner has been selected, and his name is Eric McGill. You probably haven't heard of his name, but he is the founder of Ecotvision Paranormal.
Oh, hey! I won the Scary Face contest.
Fear Face!
You're welcome? Anyway, he's joined by his case manager, Amber Wellman.
Sometimes.
Whoa, take it easy. And also, team manager, Sean Gilmore.
Eric, this isn't working!
raspberries.
Alright, that was weird. But they also have an experienced evidence review guy, Tom Javorski.
What are Skittles in time? I have no idea!
They're ripples. Ripples! I guess the very masculine Marcus Hag will be joining them, as well as Nora Custer. All jokes aside, Ecotvision Paranormal is a phenomenal team, and we're all looking forward to see what they'll find during their investigation. Thank you guys, and good luck.
Welcome back to WOTN Cleveland. Guys, it's time to win a dollar.
Nice.
Both you two. I'm not splitting this up. You don't get 50 cents each. I'm not doing it that way. I'm giving you guys both a whole dollar.
Ooh. Good, I would have left otherwise.
Dude, it's just, you know, it's in the budget. I was gonna give you 50 pennies each.
Nice.
But, you know, I decided to be generous. It's a new year. Trump's our president, so you never know. That currency could
prosperity.
Be.
Prosperity, yeah.
Anyway, all right. You guys know how to play this game? You guys seen the other episodes, right?
Yep.
All right. So give me a number between 1 and 6.
1.
Give me a number between 1 and 11.
10.
This goes for both of you two. All right, I'm not gonna. It's gonna get weird. Oh, that wasn't that bad. All right, would you go snorkeling at the world's most polluted beach for $50,000?
Yes.
Yes or no? Yes?
I guess.
Yes, all right, yeah. I agree.
Yeah.
All right, give me a number between 1 and 6.
4.
Give me a number between 1 and 11.
11.
What the? Okay. Would you be willing to have your arm surgically replaced with a Great Dane's front legs for $5 million? Yes or no? It's all ad-lib, so I'm just kind of like, I'm thinking myself if I would do it or not. Like, it's the Great Dane, like, you know, the dog.
Right, right.
It's its front legs, and that's your arms.
That would cut out a lot of extra.
But like, it'd just be like,
though,
it'd just be your.
At least it's a big dog.
Yeah, but like, they're your arms now, so you have like dog arms.
Both of them.
Yeah.
And what I'm saying is, you lose all your extracurricular.
Yeah, it's $5 million. It's for $5 million. So technically, you'll have little dog hands, but it's for $5 million.
Right.
Yes or no?
There's a lot of things you can't do.
That's what I'm worried about.
And you don't have thumbs. You don't have thumbs. How are you gonna?
Right.
I mean, you guys got. You got. I mean, I decided my answer. You guys gotta give me your answer. You ready?
What if they don't match?
There's the front legs. They gotta match, I hope.
No,
you're that guy, aren't you? You're that guy, aren't you?
Yeah.
You have to get all analytical about
Dane. Well, I mean, there's certain things I want to do.
Right. All right, so it's just the Great Dane's front legs that are your arms now for $5 million.
I'd pass on it. My wife would not go for that.
Yeah,
needs all my fingers.
Yeah, I'm gonna pass on it too. What do you say?
I'm gonna say negative.
Negative? All right, cool. Now, that's an interesting one. You know the rules. 1 through 6.
Let's go with 6.
1 through 11.
3.
3. What would you rather stick in your eye? A licorice whip or a lemon wedge?
Licorice whip.
Dude, that's like, I would take the lemon because I don't know.
Lemon will burn.
The whip would just like, you're in there. Like, you can't, at least with the wedge, you can kind of get it out.
Well, yeah. The whip, you can just, it's over quick and fast.
I'm going with the lemon.
I don't know, the whip, I feel like the whip would like, it's like, it would be harder to get out.
Yeah.
I don't know. But it doesn't matter, because you know why? You both won a dollar.
Yes.
Nice.
Hold on. This was actually in a hooker.
Oh, cool.
This one. This one was in jail. You better watch that. That was from Leroy.
Nice.
He smells pretty good. He smells like shame and ass. This is WOTN Cleveland. I am your host, Joshua Bialta, and thank you guys so much for coming on.
Thanks for having us, Josh.
That was fun. And you guys won a dollar. You better watch that one. Like, seriously.
Oh, no.
I was in the clinker
last night. That stays right there.
We'll be right back. Come on, man. What's going on?
Funk, right?
Funk. I'm talking like funk. Like, funk. Yeah, what's going on?
EDM?
Yeah. Come on.
Or funk.
KFC?
I don't know.
AT&T.
I don't know anything else outside of techno, bro.
CBC? NBC.
I guess this is funk. This is old school right here. Here
All
we
right,
go.
Let's do it.
Here we go. There we go. That's funky.
Is that funky?
That's funky.
I thought you had a drop in funk.
That's funky.
I want a drop.
Like funk, like what my like parents listen to funk?
I'm talking about like soul, brother.
Just EDM, bro.
Man,
just EDM.
Ah, motherfucker.
Just
what
EDM.
God damn it.
There we go.
One thing none of these people know. I'm going to kill myself.
That was a good trailer. I sure enjoyed that. Now, get your butt off the couch and do something with your life. I have some jobs that are hiring this week. We have an assistant broker, $11 an hour, at Douglas & Associates. So you go to douglasandassociates.com/careers. We got a human resource associate at John Carroll University, $65,000 yearly. Not bad. Go to their website, /careers, johncarrolluniversity.com/careers. We have a full-time infant nanny and toddler care for nanniesandsitters.com. It's $10 an hour. So go there, get the job, and get your butt off the couch and do something with your life. This is WOTN Cleveland, and we'll be right back. For real. Come on, dude. Dude, hey.
Tell me why I am in Cleveland, fucking Ohio, when I should be in sunny motherfucking California. This is bullshit. There's snow, ice, fucking wind. This is bullshit. I should be at home on the beach. Oh, and what's his name? Tell me again. Oh, Junior Chains? Who the fuck is that guy? What sport does he play? Okay. What else has he done? Wait a goddamn minute.
Oh. Junior Chains?
Are you the guy who's gonna make me famous?
Oh boy. We have a lot of work to do.
Sports with Nish.
What's up, Cleveland? It's your girl, Nish. I got your sports for you. Cavs, 36-16. Come on, Cavs, we're gonna win another championship just like last year. Of course, we got the good old Munsters. I don't know if there's any hockey fans out there. We got plenty of hockey fans, 23-18. Beat some more ass out there on the ice. Browns, this is our year, come on now. Super Bowl 2017. And happy Valentine's Day to all you bitches.
Thanks, Nish.
Hi there. People who are watching this trailer probably like, who's the guy in the black shirt? Well, I am the creator of the Dancing Taco Man Adventures, and
I am the Dancing Taco Man.
Did you see that?
I'm here.
What the fuck is that?
To fight crime, kick.
What the fuck? I was just talking about it. What the fuck? What
the
are
Dancing
you?
Dancing Taco Man.
Okay.
I'm here to fight crime, okay. Kick ass.
Okay then.
And dance.
You do that. Well, stay tuned. We got more episodes on the way. Thank you for watching, and this is the Dancing Taco Man in Clay.
Welcome back. That was an awesome commercial. I hope you guys liked it. I really did. I actually had to fix myself on that one. But we're gonna go to weather with, where'd he go? So weather with Wit, he's actually being currently detained right now. But this is his attorney. Weather with Wit.
Make sure you don't say anything, but just be quiet. Just don't say anything. Don't say anything at all. Just be quiet. Don't say anything.
This call may be recorded or monitored. I have a prepaid call from
Wit Morningstar
and inmate at Lake County G. Your account balance is $23.44. If you wish to accept this prepaid call, dial 0 and hold. To it. Thank you.
Oh man, thank you. What's the weather?
Shit, man, cold. Coldest this jail cell that I've been in for the past 2 weeks. Look, I'm telling you, before you hear anything else from the media, I am innocent. I am completely fucking innocent. All I know is I wake up in the morning, there's cops at my door saying I robbed a bank on Tuesday. Don't they know I robbed the bank on Friday? I even tell them, hey look, officer, I rob banks on Fridays, not Tuesdays. So they leave, and in an hour they come back with a search warrant because somebody robbed a bank on Friday. And that guy was wearing a red ski mask, but they figured, oh, okay, he just wears a ski mask.
Right, change his color.
Right. Great, I don't mean to cut you off, but the people need the weather, and like, isn't this being monitored right now as we speak? So this guard totally just heard all that.
Look,
come on now.
Look,
come on, man.
Come on. You don't understand. The food here is shit. I asked the lunch lady at the prison cafeteria for a cold cut, and you know what she did? She tried to shank me with an ice pick.
Did you make it?
I'm in the infirmary right now.
4 minutes left to lockdown.
Do you have like a newspaper or like a toilet paper of the weather?
Hang on.
For Cleveland, Ohio.
Guard, do you have a newspaper? Guard, bring it to me. He says it's cold. Go fuck yourself.
Okay. Alright, I love you too. So, weather with Wit.
He could not, have not, shall not done this crime. Anyway, it's gonna be 43 degrees today, and it might be 20 tomorrow.
Thanks, Wit! This is WOTN Cleveland. I am your host, Joshua Vialta, and it is February 11th, 2017. We've been out of the game for a little bit, but it's, you know, we're back rocking it out. And it's time for the news. So, as you guys know, election season's over. Get down! Those graphics, I tell you what, you know, they just don't, really? Donald Trump is actually coming to Youngstown next week to check out their military bases, and basically, what he quotes, to reserve a kinship with Japan over what they own. So they own Youngstown now? Great, that's, you know, moving on. Over here. Dude, it's a new year. Move the graphic over here! So, Cleveland, if you guys been in downtown, like where the ice rink is at, refuses to reopen the RTA lane. In order to do this, they need to actually pay a $12 million in federal grants to open the middle lane. Why can't they just move like the cones? That's it. There's literally the cones and like a shop in the, and I think it sells t-shirts that says welcome to Cleveland. That takes $12 million to move all that? Really? Really? Come on now. And to kind of close the news off, I think it's no sad news, but for this guy, it's kind of sad. There's a man who's wanted in Cleveland right now. He is 20 years old. Police are looking for him for stealing a box of peanut butter Twix in Rocky River. And so he went to court, and they sentenced, he was gonna do some jail time, and he booked. He literally just left the court. That was it. He ran. This man is wanted for theft with a box of peanut butter Twix. That is the news. I'm your host, Joshua Vialta. That is WOTN Cleveland, and we'll be right back. Hey, man. Hey, man.
Listen, I keep telling you it's buffering.
Well, come on. Let's go. What the fuck, man?
Give me just a couple more seconds.
Well, it's 2017. What are you doing?
Three.
Dude, come on.
Two.
This is some bullshit.
Four.
You went to three.
Three.
Come on.
Okay, it's ready. Here we go.
Let's do this.
Let's go.
All right. Yeah. Yeah. All right. I want to take off my clothes now. All right.
Hold on, let me tweet this.
Tweet this? Get the fuck out of here. Tweet WOTN Cleveland.
Gotta anticipate the drop.
Oh, what drop? I don't even know drop.
Wait, let me tweet. All right, let's go.
You gotta tweet the drop?
You gotta let people know it's coming.
Oh, jeez. Come on, man. Hurry up. We got a show to run here.
Let me give it some ambiance, a little ambiance.
All right.
Yeah.
I feel this. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's funky right
that's
there.
That's right there.
Hold on, let me send out another tweet.
Why you stop tweeting, motherfucker? Goddamn. Goddamn.
Hold on, I gotta let him know it's coming.
You gotta stop tweeting it on the show.
See, I gotta tweet to add more bass to
God
it.
Goddamn it, calm down.
There we go.
Oh, shit. Here we go.
Hold on, let me tweet one more time. It's coming.
You gotta stop
it's
tweeting.
Coming. I gotta go live with it. It's coming.
Come on, let's go. Thank you for watching. This is WOTN Cleveland. I'm your host with the most who eats toast, Joshua Vialta. Check us out. What the hell are you guys doing? Get